Hey folks, today I want to continue my drillpress restoration video here. Last time I fixed the grill so it returns to the upper position from alone, but it looks like I haven't checked everything last time, because when I turn this pulley 180 degrees up here, the grill is stuck again, so I'm not finished with this repair. When I turn it another 180 degrees, the grill returns again. I believe I know where the problem is, but to check this, I have to disassemble the grill again. I want to check two things on this shaft here. One thing is the diameter compared to the diameter of the original shaft here. And the other thing is the runout of this section of the shaft compared to the grill. This section of the shaft is already quite worn. That's also the reason why this was changed out. But down here, about 10 millimeter, there's an unused part of this shaft section. So there I can measure the original diameter, and I will also measure the worn diameter. Let's see if I can measure and film at the same time here so you can see the readings. First I will measure the original part of the shaft. And there I can measure about 19.88 millimeters. Then the lower section, the worn part, there it's 19.84 millimeters, and the upper section is also 19.84 millimeters. So that's quite cylindrical. And let's see what the new shaft has. Let's check the diameter of the new shaft now. In the lower position, we have about 19.94 millimeters, and in the upper position, 19.90 millimeters. So not really cylindrical, and also a little bit bigger than the original shaft. I think that could be already the problem here, but let's check the runout of the shaft. I've mounted a dial indicator to the grill now to check the runout. Let's see what readings we can get here. Now it's about at zero, and it's moving a lot now. Let's find the high spot. I think we have the high spot here. That's about 0.13 millimeters of total runout, so that's quite a lot runout. And now I have to find a solution to fix this runout. Okay, there are two problems with the shaft now. One is the diameter, which is a little bit too big. There would be an easy fix, just sending the diameter down a little bit while the shaft is spinning. But I can't correct the runout with this method, so I have to find another solution for that. I could disassemble the shaft from the grill and machine the shaft on the lathe to the correct dimensions. That would be absolutely possible, but also some effort to get the shaft out here and so on. So I want to try another solution, which involves my CNC machine here. And how I will do that, I will show you now. Everything is set up for grinding the shaft here now. I've mounted a grinding bit in my CNC spindle and will grind down the shaft here on the back side, moving forward and backward multiple times. I've made a little G-code for that, so I don't have to do it manually. And yeah, that's pretty much all for the grinding here. I've put a little paper on here to protect the bearings from the grinding dust. And I indicated on the grill on the back side here, so it is parallel to the Y-axis. Otherwise, the shaft won't get cylindrical after the grinding. And that the grinding here works the shaft has to spin while grinding. For that I have mounted this motor here I had lying around, and the motor is driven by this variable frequency drive, so I can change the speed a little bit. And when I turn it on, it looks like that. So, pretty much a quite easy setup, I think, compared to disassemble the shaft from the grill and try to get it to the right dimensions on the lathe. And let's start with the grinding and see how it's going. First I've marked the shaft blue a little bit, so I can see where the grinding bit touches the shaft and removes material. Here you can see the first roughing pass I did. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to remove a lot of material each pass because the setup was not very rigid and also the grinding bit wasn't spinning as fast as I would liked it. The important thing is when you grind something like this is to be patient and don't rush something, because the things will get very inaccurate if you don't take your time. It needs to grind this down. Especially multiple spring passes in the end are very important to get good dimensions. Grinding is done now. The result is pretty good. Not as good as I thought it could be, but it will be good enough for the application this shaft is needed for. It looks quite rough, but it feels very smooth, so that's okay. Down here I have to remove the material with a file. I wasn't able to reach it with the grinding bit, so I will do that now. And yeah, the diameter is already a little bit on the low side, so I wasn't able to grind the complete shaft here, but that's not much left, so that's okay. Let's check the diameter of the ground shaft now. At the front it is 19.88 millimeters, and in the back it is 19.84 millimeters. Not perfectly cylindrical because the alignment wasn't perfect, I think, but that's okay for this application now because the shaft is thin enough on every spot now. The runout is a lot better now, about 0.02 millimeter, and that's definitely good enough for this application now. I also used some sandpaper to remove the grinding marks that were left. I used up to 400 grit sandpaper and that worked really well. Everything is assembled now, I need for testing. And this is the position where it worked last time. And of course this time it also works. Didn't expect that something else. And this is the position where it was stuck last time. And now it also works. So it looks like the fix was successful. And I hope there won't be any other problems with the quill here, because it's already the second fix. But I think that's it for today's video, and I hope you liked it. And if you want to stay updated with my project here and with my channel, please subscribe and don't forget to turn on the notifications. See you next time.